So we're here in Indonesia working on a project about natural hazards and reducing risk. And we're doing that in collaboration with partners, University of Gadjah Mada. Well, the project involves building partnerships and working relationships between organisations with a responsibility for managing hazards.
Indonesia is a very large country with a very large population, about 250 million people. Yeah, Indonesia has a very similar geomorphological condition with New Zealand because we have a lot of mountains and then forests, big river. Many people try to find the place for living in flat area or near the river valley or near the coastline. Due to rapid growth of Indonesian population, a lot of people are working hard for their living, for their family, and they pay less attention for disaster risk reduction. They just think how to live and to feed their family. Indonesia is located at Ring of Fire, close to the plate boundaries, where this plate boundary initiates earthquake and also tsunami. And then the complexity of geological conditions make Indonesia also very vulnerable for landslide and also flood disaster. Similar like New Zealand, we have so many active volcanoes, more than 100, and a lot of people living surrounding the volcanoes. Yeah, when volcano erupts, a lot of disaster may affect the surrounding area. After 2004, Sumatran earthquake and tsunami, a lot of disaster we have in Indonesia, like earthquake in Padang, in Bengkulu, in Yogyakarta, and then also volcanic eruption in several islands, and also we have flood disaster almost every year, so many kind of disaster. In this project, we would like to learn, we would like to change our way of thinking.
So we want to shift the focus from the aftermath, fixing up the damage after an event, to a focus on how can we prevent some of that damage from occurring. And the sorts of things we're talking about are building better and safer infrastructure, better housing, looking at planning for development and communities, community preparedness, response planning, evacuation route planning, and better education in communities. In doing that, we hope to reduce the impacts and I guess look towards a future where we're not just waiting for events to happen and picking up the pieces afterwards, but being proactive and looking at how we can build resilience in the face of future disasters and lives are saved. The project is a 5-year project, and the reason for that is that change can sometimes take a long time. We also want the project and its outcomes to be sustainable, so that when we leave and we've finished our work with the districts, the work will continue.